Hey guys, good morning everyone. Welcome back to the online class. As today, you can see here a word is written, that is recap. Recap means what? Recap means what we have seen earlier, we are just going to revise that. Okay, so this session is about that what you have seen last week, we are just going to revise that. Okay, and what you have seen yesterday, we are going to revise with that. Okay, now let's begin. And we'll see which are the topics we are going to discuss about, okay? Let's see. So today, we are going to learn about direct and indirect object. We are going to learn about direct and indirect object, okay? Then, we'll see about how to identify direct and indirect object, okay? And then, we'll see about transitive and intransitive verb. Transitive and intransitive verb. And then, we'll see about that how to identify transitive and intransitive verb in a sentence. Okay, now let's see and let's begin with direct and indirect object. Okay, let's begin about from direct and indirect object. See here, direct object which asks the question. Now you have to use the comment section and you write it down in the comment section that what does it ask. Okay, you have time, you just use that time. I won't give much more time. Okay, in this explanation, you just have to write the answers, okay? Because I'm not going to give you so much time, okay? So, direct object asks the question. Yeah, it asks the question, what? And I will see whose answer will be the first and whose answer will come first, okay? So, direct object asks the question, what? Indirect object asks the question. Indirect object will ask the question. So, indirect object will ask the question whom. Okay, indirect object will ask the question whom. Let's see the example and we'll just make a clear that how to identify direct and indirect object in a sentence. Okay, let's see. Example is given, Phil gave the dog a bone. Phil gave the dog a bone. So, for asking, for knowing, for identifying direct object, we have to ask question what. So, Phil gave what? Phil gave a bone. So, a bone will be a direct object. And for finding out the indirect object, we will ask the question whom. Phil gave whom? Phil gave the bone to whom? So, Phil gave a bone to the dog. To the dog. See here. Phil gave the dog a bone. Gave is a verb. The dog will indirect object and a bone is a direct object. Why the dog is indirect object? Because it asks the question whom. And why a bone is a direct object? Because it asks the question what. Phil gave whom and Phil gave what. When they ask the question of what, it will be direct object. When it will ask the question of whom, then it will be said to be indirect object. Okay. Now let's move to the another slide. There you have to take a revise what you have seen in earlier slide. Okay, so here what you have to do, you just have to find out the direct and indirect object where the arrows are given. Okay, just there you have to tell which one is direct and which one is indirect object. I won't give you much time. Okay, so I showed him the photo. What will be him and what will be the photo? Your time starts now and just use the comment section and give the answer quickly. Okay, you just have you have the time now. Use that time and please write it down in the comment section. And it is just a rapid fire round. Okay, just write the answers quickly. Him, what will be the him, and the photo, what will be the photo. For direct object, आप direct object लिखने के लिए D use कर सकते हैं, indirect object use करते हैं, identify करने के लिए I लिख सकते हैं, ठीक है? Direct के लिए D, indirect के लिए I. So, him will be indirect object and the photo will be direct object. Because him, I showed what, the photo will be direct object. I showed whom, I showed him. Him will be indirect object. Okay, ask the question. Aapko sirf question puchna what or whom. I showed what, I showed whom. The answer will come. Uske hisab se aap dekh lo kaun sa direct hai, kaun sa indirect hai. Okay, next question. Let's move to the another question. That is, I gave the book to Amy. I gave the book to Amy. I gave what? I gave the book. I gave to whom? I gave to Amy. So when the question will ask of what, it will be dash. And when the question will ask about whom, it will be dash. Then see, the when it will ask the question what, it will be direct, means why I gave what, the book, and I gave to whom, Amy. It asked the question whom, so it will be indirect object. Okay, last one, let's move to our third one. Third one, she gave them a present. She gave them a present. So tell me, what will be the them and what will be a present? Just use the comment section and comment there. Quickly. It's a rapid fire round. Quickly do that. Quickly do that. Okay. Just write there, what is them? What is a present? It's your time. Use that time and please answer it in the comment section. And you'll be able to, means I will able to know that how many of you have learned direct and indirect object. Okay, this is the way that how to means know that you have learned direct or indirect object or not. Okay, so tell me, I think much time I have given you. Them will be, yes, it will be indirect object, and a present will be direct object. Okay, so it's done. Now let's move to the another slide, that is talking about, you have to tell whether the underlined words are direct or indirect object. Okay, you have to tell whether the underlined words are direct or indirect object. Let's see, first question, she sent her friend an email. She sent her friend an email. What will be her friend? Use the comment section and write D or I. D for direct object and I for indirect object. I hope you are writing, you are using that comment section, right? Use that comment section and you give your best and just write the answer. So what will be her friend? She sent an email to whom? And you know, to whom kiske liye question kiya jata hai? Yes, it asks the questions whom, then it will be indirect object. Second, Alice wrote a book on the French Revolution. Alice wrote a book on the French Revolution. Alice wrote what? So what, when the questions ask what, it will be, write D or I for your answer. Direct for D, indirect for I. Written? So yes, it will be direct object. Okay, see the third one, he gave them a bag. What will be them here? Aap lo I use kar sakte ho indirect ke liye, D use kar sakte ho direct object ke liye, theek hai? So he gave them a bag. He gave to whom? He gave them. Them will be indirect object. Yes. Fourth, I need your help. I need what? I need what? And when the question asks of what, it will be, yes, it will be direct object. Okay, let's move to the another slide and we are going to learn about, now we'll learn about transitive and intransitive verb. Okay, we'll learn about transitive and intransitive verb. So tell me, first we are going to learn about transitive verb. A transitive verb is a verb that contains object. A transitive verb is a verb that contains object, right? So tell me, object means it contains more than one object, and that will be direct and indirect object. Okay, direct and indirect object. As I have earlier in two slides, we have seen about direct and indirect object, means transitive verb will have object and it will have more than one object. Means there will be two objects, one will be direct and one will be indirect object. It means direct and indirect object are possibly, means that will be, the sentence will be, the verb will be transitive verb. Okay, kyunki direct object ask karta question what and indirect question karta whom. Okay, example aapne ye pehle bhi liya hai, abhi fir se main ye lungi for clear your view. Phil gave the dog a bone. So let's see, Phil gave the dog a bone. You know, the dog, a bone is a object. Okay, because transitive verb needs an object. Okay, Phil is a subject, gave verb, and the dog, a bone, is a object, right? Complete. Now here, this is a two object, means there are more than one object. Two object is there, one will be direct and one will be indirect. Now use the comment section and tell me which one is direct and which one is indirect. Because earlier in two slides we have seen which one is direct and which one is indirect. Now it is very easy for you to identify. Use D for direct and use I for indirect object. I think you have used it. Yep. Let's see. So object, indirect object and direct object. Indirect will be the dog and direct will be a bone, because the dog will ask the question, Phil gave to whom the dog? Phil gave what? A bone. Phil gave a bone. So hence it is clear that it is a transitive verb. It is a transitive verb because it asks the question, because it has an object and which asks the question what and whom. So it is very clear in a short that transitive verb will ask the question what and whom. Agar what or whom ka question wo pooch sakta hai sentence after the verb, it is said to be transitive verb. Now let's see about intransitive verb. Okay, let's see about intransitive verb. An intransitive verb is a simply defined as a verb that does not take an object to complete its meaning. Yes, intransitive verb is a verb, okay, which simply defined as a verb that does not take object. वो उसको object की ज़रूरत नहीं उनका अपना complete करने के लिए, ठीक है? It means there's no word in the sentence that tells who or what receives the action of the verb. Yes, correct. It won't ask the question who and what. ये ऐसा कोई जैसे हम लोग ने transitive verb में पढ़ा, whom or what अगर question कर रहा है, it means it is transitive verb. Okay? अगर who or what answer नहीं करेगा question, then it is said to be an intransitive verb. For example, we'll see. Alexis cleaned on Sunday. Alexis cleaned what? Alexis cleaned whom? We'll ask the question. So tell me, Alexis cleaned what? कुछ समझ में आ रहा है? कुछ answer आ रहा है? नहीं आ रहा है. Alexis cleaned whom? कुछ answer आ रहा है? नहीं आ रहा है. Right? It won't give any answer to what or whom. It means it is a intransitive verb. Intransitive verb का मतलब ये होता है वो कभी भी question नहीं करेगा like who or whom or what. Okay? Here two example given. Okay? You just take a recap of that and just identify which one is transitive and which one is intransitive verb. Okay? सी sang in the assembly. पहले इसको देखना है first वाले को. And सी sang the national anthem in the assembly है, ठीक है? अभी आपको ये बताना है first one वाला I है कि T है, और second वाला I है या T है. I means intransitive और T means transitive. Okay? So अभी जल्दी से comment section को use करो और बताओ first one वाला क्या है, second one वाला क्या है. First one वाला I है T है या second वाला I या T है. Okay? I just hope you have given the answer. See, she sang in the assembly and she sang the national anthem in the assembly. We'll ask the same pattern pe jayenge aur wahan puchenge what or whom ka question. Theek hai? So, she sang wale mein pehle puchenge, she sang first wale mein, she sang what and she sang whom. Theek hai? Question puch liya hum logo ne. See, ab second wale mein dekhna hai. She sang the national anthem in the assembly. तो सी sang what and सी sang whom. आपको ये देखना है किस में आंसर निकल रहा है. फर्स्ट वाले में देखो आप, सी sang what, आंसर आया? नहीं, आंसर नहीं आया. अभी देखो सी sang whom, आंसर आया? नहीं आया. ठीक है, अभी सेकंड वाले में देखते हैं. सी sang what, सी sang the national anthem. She sang the national anthem. Answer आ गया, question आ गया, what का answer आ गया ना. So it is said to be transitive verb. And जिसमें answer नहीं आया, it is said to be intransitive verb. Okay? यहाँ पे गलती से मैंने whom का yes लिख दिया, because whom तो यहाँ पे question पूछ नहीं रहा. But it's okay. आपको बस इतना ध्यान में रखना है, what or whom जैसा question आएगा तो it will said to be transitive verb. और what or whom में answer नहीं देगा, then it is intransitive verb. तो first वाला intransitive होगा, second वाला transitive होगा. ठीक है, अभी let's check to the another example, okay? Identify the verb and state whether the verb is transitive or intransitive verb, okay? Let's see. My mother gave me a sweater for my birthday. You have to ask the question gave what and gave whom, ठीक है? आप लोगों ने क्वेश्चन कर लिया. माई मदर, आपको बस बताना है ट्रांजिटिव और इंट्रांजिटिव. ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब वही होंगे जिसमें हम क्वेश्चन कर सकते हैं व्हाट और हुम. अगर व्हाट और हुम का आंसर आ गया, इट इज़ सेड टू बी ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब, ठीक है? और अगर व्हाट और हुम का आंसर नहीं आता तो इट इज़ सेड टू बी इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब, ठीक है? और ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब में दो टाइप के ऑब्जेक्ट होते हैं, दैट इज डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. एक वाला व्हाट वाला डायरेक्ट होता है और हुम वाला इनडायरेक्ट होता है, ठीक है? अभी लेट्स चेक दैट. सो माई मदर गेव what, gave what, so gave sweater and that will be direct object. And now we'll ask the question, my mother gave whom, my mother gave me, and that will be indirect object, okay? So hence it is said to be transitive verb, right? My mother gave what, my mother gave whom, ye dono question aa gaya, so that is said to be in transitive verb, okay? Now let's see another example. Neeta came in the room. Now again you have to ask the question what and whom. ठीक है? Neeta came. Came what? कोई answer नहीं आ रहा यार. Came whom? No answer still. Right? Came what? No answer. Came whom? No answer. When came what or whom का questions का answer नहीं आता है, then it is said to be what? It is said to be intransitive verb. It is said to be intransitive verb. Okay, so we have seen about transitive, intransitive. We have seen about direct and indirect object. We have seen how to identify what question asks direct and indirect object. So we have seen about direct object today. We have seen about indirect object today, and we have also seen about transitive verb with डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट ही ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब में होगा, इसीलिए वो क्वेश्चन करेगा व्हाट और हुम, और व्हाट और हुम का क्वेश्चन का आंसर वो दे दिया, इट मीन दैट इज ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. ओके, फोर्थ वी हैव सीन अबाउट इनट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. ओके, इनट्रांजिटिव वर्ब का मतलब ये है दैट इट विल, इट वोंट गिव द आंसर व्हाट और हुम, इट इज ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड विदाउट एन ऑब्जेक्ट, एंड दैट इज सेड टू बी intransitive verb. So thank you for all watching this, and thank you for participating in comment section, and I will announce after this means watching the video of yours, means when you will watch the video, and after that I'll say who won and who came first, whose answer was the fastest. Okay, so thank you everyone, and really it means a lot. Have a nice day to all, and complete your assignments well. All the best to all.